Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for participating to the ESERA 2021 conference, and especially our study, which is titled as Improving Students' Understanding of the Ecological Footprint Within the Context of Everyday Life. I'm Georgios Malandrakis, the highlighted name here on the left. And below are the names of all members of the research group that contributed to this study. The ecological footprint now, it is a valuable resource accounting tool that assesses the human pressure on the environment and links our everyday activities with the environmental burden caused by the human needs. Now, a few words about the literature review that led us to this study. We have identified many studies about the calculation of the individual ecological footprint where various age groups have participated. However, there is a gap in these studies because all of them are focused on the reduction of participants' ecological footprint and ways of how they can reduce it. So there are no studies researching the actual understanding of the ecological footprint concept in itself. So, based to this finding, our main goal was to assess the learning effect of the developed educational materials on a master student's understanding about the ecological footprint concept. A few words about our project. It is called EU STEPS, which means Enhancing University Sustainability Teaching and Practices. It is a 3 years long Erasmus Plus project, and here are the four universities that participate in the consortium. They are Aristotle University from Thessaloniki, the University of Aveiro and Aberta from Portugal, University of Siena from Italy, and last but not least, of course, the Global Footprint Network, which is a non-governmental organization who has introduced the concept of ecological footprint. Our target groups throughout the project are all European university students and the wider academic community, meaning educators, administrative and technical staff, and university authorities. The EU STEP project has two main goals: the development of a teaching module customized for the four target groups, academics, students, authorities and administrative staff, and the development of an online calculator for assessing the ecological footprint of universities. Now, a few words about the educational module that we developed from the first part of our project. It has a duration ranging from 6 to 12 hours. 6 hours is the core part and 12 hours is the extended version. It has 7 topics. 4 of them are the core topics and 3 are optional. At the implementation of this module, all universities implemented this in their students. The teaching was in the national languages of the participants, and the teaching took place during the March and April of 2020. Last year, during the first phase of the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, a few words about the participants' characteristics. Initially participated 52 students from all universities of the consortium. However, here we present the results only from 22 of them, as some of the students didn't field either the pre-test or the post-test or both of them. So we actually have data only from 13 master students from University of Aveiro, where the teaching took place face-to-face. These students were from the Department of Social, Political and Territorial Sciences, and from 9 students from Aristotle University from Greece, from Department of Primary Education. For our research tool, we use the EFDI, it is Ecological Footprint Diagnostic Instrument, which is applied online through the Lyme survey, and data collected a week before and about a week after the end of teaching. A few more words about the instrument that we used. The EFDI, it's a three-tier test, and it is comprised of 13 questions related with the concept of the ecological footprint. We call it three-tier test because for each one of the 13 questions we had three sub-questions, three tiers. The first tier is related with the content. The second tier is related with the reasoning, explaining why the first tier is correct. And the third tier, it is the confidence tier, where the participants rate how confident they feel in their previous answer. All questions were in closed form. The analysis made through the SPSS, and we used the non-parametric Wilcoxon sign rank test because the number of participants were too small, just 22, and the data were very unbalanced. Now a few words about the results. As you see, we have a lot of numbers here, but please focus on the green cells. Starting from the Aveiro University, we see that significant differences were recorded in the content tier and in the reasoning tier, while we in Aristotle University we identified significant difference and in the content and in the confidence tier, but also when all three tiers are combined. Is the bottom right cell. By saying combined three tiers, meaning that students had to answer correctly and in the first tier, in the content, and in the second tier, which is the reasoning, and to feel very confident in their answer. Now, if we treat the all participants as one group, we realize that significant differences are observed in all five comparisons. From the previous results, we realized that the significant differences were observed in half of the comparison, in 5 among 10 comparisons. And if all 22 participants are treated as one group, all differences are significant. These two indicate that our educational module helped a lot the master students to realize the concept of ecological footprint. However, there are some limitations, especially regarding the number of participants in each group. There are only 9 and 13. There are also some difference in their academic background. We have students from Department of Education and students from Sciences and Department. And there also may be cultural differences because the participants were from two different countries. So further research is needed and with a larger number of participants, in order where both undergraduate and master students have to participate, in order our results to be more reliable. Now, what is next with our project? We have already developed, tested and finalized the students module this year, the 2021, and we have also prepared and finalized the respective teacher's book for this module, and we have accomplished an education educators training event in September 2020. We have also developed a respective module for the administrative staff, which also has been finalized and respective training accomplished the May of 2021. The future steps are to develop the ecological footprint calculator about universities, which is under development, and this will help us to manage the reduction of the ecological footprint of the universities, not only the participating universities, but all universities around the world. Here are some key references for our study, and thank you for your attention.